2018 Nicaraguan protests flight of Nicaraguan citizens. Since the end of July and the beginning of August, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Worship and the Directorate of Immigration and Foreigners of Costa Rica reported a moderate increase in the entry of Nicaraguans into Costa Rican territory. According to the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees, UNHCR, an average of 200 Nicaraguans per day apply for asylum in Costa Rica, overwhelming the country's immigration authorities. In addition, the commissioner reported that about 8,000 Nicaraguan refuge requests have been reported since the beginning of the protests. Among the Nicaraguans who have sought refuge in Costa Rica are several university leaders, who fled Nicaragua after constant threats that forced them to leave the country. Among them the university leader Victor Cuadras Andino. The vice president and minister of foreign affairs of Costa Rica, Epsi Campbell, reported that more than 1,000 Nicaraguan refugee claims have been denied, in order to avoid an immigration crisis and to prevent the entry of illegal persons and maintain security in the region. On August 3, 2018, Nicaraguan singer-songwriter Carlos Mejia Godoy reported that he left his country because his life is in danger as part of protests against the government of President Daniel Ortega, of whom he is critical in adding to the hundreds of Nicaraguans who have refuge requests the Nicaraguan Association for Human Rights, AMPI, highlighted in the rescue of injured, detained or harassed protesters in the Nicaraguan protests of 2018 announced on Sunday, August 5, 2018 the temporary closure of their offices due to serious threats and siege by illegal armed groups sponsored and supported by the president of Nicaragua Daniel Ortega and Rosario Murillo. The flight from Nicaragua of the human rights activist Alvaro Leyva, after the popular singer-songwriter Carlos Mejia Godoy, for threats attributed to pro-government groups, triggered the alarms between humanitarian agencies, the UN and the OAS. Representatives of the Special Follow-up Mechanism for Nicaragua, MESONAI, and the Office of the United Nations High Commissioner for Human Rights, ACNUD, discussed this situation.